Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. This is episode 19 of Movie Monster, and today for the very first time I'm having a guest in my channel. AJ from AJ's Movie Place is here with us. Thanks AJ for joining us. How are you?
I'm very well. Thank you for inviting me on. It's nice to see you again. Where's
Nice to see
your
you too.
parrot?
What's that,
Where's your
sorry?
parrot? Where's your parrot?
She's with the ladies because look, she's
Oh,
doing a lot of nasty. I just don't want to interrupt this dialogue. Okay, so today
fair
I
enough.
just left her behind.
That's the only reason I came on, was to see a parrot, not you.
Yeah, I know. Look, anyway,
I'm
next
joking,
time,
I'm joking.
I'm pretty sure we're gonna enjoy this session. So next time I can bring her, okay, for you.
Yeah, I'm just joking with you. I'm just
All
joking.
right, no worries. So, what did you prepare for us today, AJ?
Well, some films. Well, you asked me to pick my five favorite films.
Yes, five favorite. I really want to see that because you have a massive collection there. I can see that. I just want to know the number one to five. That would be so fun to watch for us.
Well, I'm going to disappoint you
I don't think so. We
because
have total respect.
I've picked five films that mean a lot to me in a sense. One of them is my favorite film of all time. I've never actually done a top 10 films of all time video. I've never done a top 20 all times because I find it to be an impossible task. I don't think that I could actually list you five films that are my favorite films. I think they would change daily. Do you know what I mean? So what
Yeah,
I've
I
done is I've
understand.
prepared five films for you that mean a lot to me, that over the years I've gravitated towards extensively. But that's not to say there are not better films in my collection, if that makes sense.
I understand. Yeah, you
So
have
better
five
and
movies at
favorite.
all. You have five movies for us, but you still have some other best movies.
Well, yeah, I mean these are films that I watch a lot. So they
Okay.
would be very much in that top tier. They would be in the top 10, top 20 maybe. Yes. Yeah, most definitely.
That totally makes sense. I'm so excited to see that. Let's see.
Okay. Oh, you want me to start?
Okay.
Okay. All right, so the first one I pulled, which is a a Christmas staple.
Die
Die Hard.
Hard.
With
Yes.
Bruce Willis. Yeah, so what do you want me to say? What do you want me to say about
Well, it
it?
is 4K. And slip cover. Look, I'm also
Oh.
interested in the design. You know, it's beautiful.
Oh,
It looks
okay,
beautiful.
all right. Yeah, this is 4K with slip cover. Yeah, with a couple of discs inside. Now, obviously, I wasn't old enough to see this in the cinema when it came out.
Really?
Yeah, I
When
was about.
did it came out? Do you remember?
This came out in 1987. Or is it
97.
98?
Okay.
Or is it 88? It was 88 or 87. 88, sorry. So I
Okay.
would have been 11 years old.
Yes, it's not possible. I understand. Yeah. We have a lot there.
Oh, there you go. Yeah, I lost
Okay.
it for a minute. It's frozen. Yeah, so it was an 18 certificate. I was 11 when it came out, so obviously I couldn't go to see it. So obviously I saw it on video. I had it on VHS, ex rental copy. And I was a fan of Bruce Willis at that point. I'd followed him through Moonlighting. And then I remember the concept for the film, and I thought to myself, well, I'm not gonna like this. Do you know what I mean? It's a bottled location. It's one building. How much action can you get out of one building? And then, obviously, when I saw the film, I was blown away. And it's a film that I do watch. I mean, do I think it's a Christmas film? It's got Christmas in its DNA, but Christmas gives me an excuse to watch it yearly. Do you know what
Okay.
I'm saying?
I understand. Look, actually, I've seen that movie many times in the op shops. And look, I have a lot of movies in my collection too. And I know Die Hard, but I don't remember the details. Does it include any Christmas thing inside in the movie? Or I don't know
Well,
if.
it's set on Christmas Eve at a party
Okay. That's the point.
Yeah, in the so there is a lot of sort of I think every scene almost includes something Christmassy, whether it's Christmas lights, Christmas decor. Do you know what I mean? There's a lot of
Okay.
Christmas spread throughout the film, but yeah, the film could be set at any time of year. Do you know what I mean? It just happens to be set at Christmas. Yeah,
But if it's
and
your in your list, I mean, I have total respect on your selections on the movies. So I believe I need to give it a try after all that years, because I'm pretty sure I watched it a couple of times on TV, maybe when I was a child, but I really don't remember the details. So
okay.
I'll pay attention to it again. That's
Well, to me,
nice.
that's very interesting that you haven't, you know, that it's a film that you've not watched for a long time. I think that's
It
incredible.
happens sometimes, you know, because look,
Yeah,
this
no, I
is
know.
like an ocean. There are a lot of movies out there. But
Absolutely.
most of the Clint Eastwood movies, this Western cowboy movies, I've seen them all. But look, these are old movies, but when I'm watching them again and again, wait a minute, did I see this one? I'm just remembering a couple of scenes and then yes, I've seen it. So, you know, it happens. I'm sure when I watch Die Hard again, then I'll remember the details and yes, okay, this is the one. So
Yeah, and obviously it sort of set the bar for action films, and it sort of changed the action genre. From that point on, there were so many sort of diehard rip-offs. You know, Under Siege, Passenger 57, Air Force One, Speed. Do you know what I mean? They all had their origins in Die Hard, all those sort of films.
I've seen the Speed in the cinema, by the way. I remember that one. Seeing it in
Okay,
the cinema.
cool. So do you want me to move on to my next one?
Yeah, sure, why not? Oh, we're going fast.
Well, no, we can slow down. Ask me, you know what I mean? So the next film I've picked, and again, there are far better films, if that makes sense, but this is a film that I love and adore from 1992, and it
Okay.
is The Army of Darkness.
Oh, look at this cover art. That's
Oh, no,
beautiful.
this is a region one. This is an American
American one.
a release,
Look,
this
I
one.
was about to say you have a lot of beautiful releases in UK, but now you say that it's from America. So okay. Oh,
Yeah,
it's
that's from America. I have several versions of this. It's actually got four discs in it.
What are
And there
all
are
those
different.
discs? I mean, one is
You've got,
Blu-ray, surely, but
what you've got in here, you've got the theatrical cut on 4K, the theatrical cut then on Blu-ray, then you've got the director's cut on Blu-ray, and then you've got the international cut on Blu-ray.
What? A
There's
lot of cuts out there.
Several different versions of this film. And I'm not big into horror. I'm not a massive horror fan. But obviously, have you seen Army of Darkness?
Yes, I have it in my collection, but
Yes.
just one version. Sorry, two versions. One DVD and one Blu-ray. I don't know if they are different. I need to check it
That's
out.
interesting because Australia did release, and I've got it upstairs, a version, and it's in a DVD size pack. But it's got Blu-ray in it as well. It's got a nice sort of die cut slip. And it's got all the versions in it. It's got all the different
Look,
versions in it.
I've seen it in 2000. 17. I've seen one copy in JB Hi-Fi. It was very
Yeah.
expensive. I didn't buy it. Now I'm crying.
That's right.
You know this thing.
Yeah.
Buy it now or cry later. So,
Yeah, it's a lot of white cover. It's like a white cover. Yeah.
the white cover.
Yeah, I did wonder if it was out of print now. I've had that for some time. So this is essentially everything on that is on here. But obviously you've got a 4K upscale for one or 4K version of one of the films. Which is a shame the others weren't upgraded to 4K because the theatrical cut isn't my go-to cut of the film. But there we go. I just like the artwork on that. I thought it was fantastic looking. I mean, I do have two steelbooks for this. I do have the
It is
movie poster one
beautiful.
as well.
Look, this cover design, it's new to surely. I mean, it's
But
new
what this
artist.
done, this film, it introduced me to Bruce Campbell. It introduced me to the Evil Dead franchise. This was the first one I saw. And then I went back and watched Evil Dead 1 and 2. And I like the mix of horror and humor because I'm not a big horror fan. when horror steps into the when horror includes a bit of humour, I think it's great. And obviously, this film goes a bit against convention, horror convention, in that you've got a male protagonist.
Yeah, you know I mean, you've got a horror
female antagonist, and I just think Ash himself is a cool character. An Army of Darkness over the years. Obviously, you've had the spin-off, you've had the TV series of Ash versus Evil Dead, which I adored. You've had comic books from Dynamite Comics.
Do you like the TV series? I've seen most of them, but I still don't. I've one season to go, I guess, to finish it.
It was a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun, yeah. I enjoyed it. It's for Bruce Campbell more than anything else.
Yeah, I know.
Bruce Campbell's just, you know, I mean, I've read his biographies as well that he's done, a couple of his books I've got on the bookshelf down there. So when you say, you know, like I said about favourite films, obviously I've got films like Shawshank Redemption, which is a far better film, but something like Army of Darkness I'd watch more often. Do you know what I mean?
I do, Army of Darkness. Look, I have the DVD and Blu-ray. The white cover one, I've got it, but just single disc version, not the... But still have one, so it's something, I guess. And a DVD version, but the resolution is not good. Even on a standard TV, it's not no good, so having Blu-rays better, I guess.
Yeah, I still have DVD versions of it as well. I've got several versions of it.
That's nice. Look, AJ, I like that movie too. It's in my list, not in five, but Bruce Campbell. Look, if even you have just one single man in the movie, Bruce Campbell, that would be fun. Still fun, isn't it?
Yeah. But at the moment, because I'm doing a series, and the episode, well, funny that episode two of my new series is actually airing right this minute. Which is called Desert Island Discs. And in that, what I'm doing is I'm going through each shelf one at a time, and I'm picking that one film off of that shelf that I would take with me if I was stranded on a desert island, or that one film that I'd want with me. Okay. And part of me doing that series is because I've never done a top 5, top 10, top 20 films, because it just, like I said, it always seems so daunting a task. So what I'm doing is I'm doing each shelf, picking one film from that shelf that I would take with me. The idea is flawed in that I could pick something from that shelf, then I drop to the next shelf, pick something, but on the next shelf there's something else there which is far better than the one that I picked from the shelf above. So it's still not a distinct top 10, top 20 films of all time. I may do it when that series comes to an end.
Yeah, I believe for the collectors like us, there won't be number 1 to 5 at all, I guess, because there are many movies to pick from there. So
that's right, maybe, yeah. So the next one, the next one I've picked from 1987, a film that I love and adore, Near Perfect film, a film that can't be made today because of genders and testosterone not in existence anymore. And that is Predator. Oh,
yes. The classic one with Schwarzenegger.
Yes. Beautiful. Now, I do have this on 4K as well in a sort of, in a box set, you know, with the four Predators. Is it four or three Predator films in it? I don't know how many's in the box set. I think it's four in that box set. But yeah, so the very first Predator film, which again, a film that I can just watch any time. You know, they've never improved upon the design of the Predator. This is one where he looks the best. The film is so, you know, macho. It's got so much testosterone in every scene of this film. It's like, do you know what I mean? Right. This is like a proper man's film. This is a man's movie. And they just can't. They wouldn't be able to make it again today because of sort of agendas that exist in Hollywood and that. You just wouldn't get away with it.
Yeah, I'm listening. Yes.
I remember with that one. I remember before I saw the film, owning an issue of Fangoria magazine, which had the Predator on the cover. Fangoria wasn't ever a magazine that I really read, but I picked this issue up because I was interested in Predator.
Yeah.
And and again, anything Predator, I'll pick up. So that would be probably in the top five. That would make the top five.
I have two questions. Do you remember the first time you're watching Predator for the very first time?
No, I don't.
Me too. I mean, but I remember it was so exciting because we didn't know what's that thing. Is it an alien or it's a monster, whatever it is? It was really exciting. But even now, when I'm watching it, I still feel the same thing. It's
yeah,
timeless classic. And another question for you. What do you think about the Predator from 2018? Or
The Predator.
What do you think about that?
I think it's a very ill-conceived movie.
Uh-huh.
It's a film. It doesn't. Okay, it's a bad film. I think it's a bad film.
I'm glad you said that.
but uh-huh. It doesn't bore me.
Uh-huh.
I don't think it's a boring film. I mean, I can put it on. I can watch it, and it flows really nice. And I'm not bored watching it, but I know that it's not a good film. It made. And part of the intrigue of that film for me is that I know that there was this other version out there that was that we didn't see, that they cut the final third act off and then they refilmed the entire third act. They actually had Edward James Olmos, the actor, was originally in the film because he mm-hmm. would have been at the end of the film. And there's all this stuff cut, and there's photos of this stuff online where to fight the big Predator, these people, you know, the army guys, they went to Area 51 or got took to Area 51 where there was two other Predator there that were working with people that were in Area 51 and working with humans. And these Predators were dressed in fatigue garb, and there's images out there of these two Predators sat upon tanks, or these are these sort of military vehicles, not tanks, but your sort of personnel carriers, and they're sat on top with I think the black fella is in the film in the gun turret and this sort of a thing. So there's this other version of the film that never came to be, and that just intrigues me. When something like that happens, it intrigues me about the film. You know,
I understand. Yeah, look, you like the franchise, so
yes,
I believe. Yeah, it might be a good movie, but maybe they need to make some elections in the scenes and redo the movie.
Yeah,
the best part.
I mean, I'd love to see the other version of it if it was ever put together, even a rough cut. I'd be intrigued to see that ending. You know, but it ain't a great film. It was, you know, trying to change up the, the Predator's reason for being, the upgrading and all this sort of a thing. It wasn't a great film.
But what's the next one?
It had Thomas Jane in it. So there we go.
Okay, that makes sense. So after this conversation, I believe I'll give it a try again, once more. Maybe
it's not a good film. It's not a good film. It's not boring. It's not a boring film.
But you said there are some good scenes in that, so I can pick some of them and enjoy it somehow. Who knows?
Well, no, all the best stuff, I think, hit the cutting room floor. But there we go.
Okay, if you say so.
But speaking of Thomas Jane, so the next one I picked, and this probably isn't in my top five, most definitely not, but it's a favourite film when I go. And it is The Punisher.
Oh my God! Look at this cover art. You have beautiful versions out there.
Oh, that's not a proper cover. That's not a proper. I've got a lenticular on the back.
Lenticular. Beautiful.
This here was I think I bought that lenticular separate off of someone.
Someone
who makes them.
I love that lenticular thing. Yeah.
Yeah, and then that front cover art was actually sent to me by Matt as a magnet. Uh-huh.
Okay.
So I've actually attached it to that steelbook there.
Ah, all right. Okay. It's still beautiful.
This is just a standard Blu-ray steelbook. However, I do have multiple versions of this film.
Mm-hmm. This is a beautiful movie. I like it so much. The only negative thing is the Punisher is so... He's not that Punisher. He's a quiet man. How can I put it? He's not mean, you know?
No. For me, this is a, you know, since my comic collecting days of young... Uh-huh. The Punisher's always been the character that I've gravitated towards. And this film here is I love it. There's an extended cut of the film that's far better. I don't know if you've got it in America or not. I don't know. I'm not sure. Oh, sorry, in Australia. I sourced it from Germany. It's like 17 minutes longer. So there's parts of the film that are, yeah, that were hit the cutting room floor, that have been put back in, subplots and all this sort of thing. But yeah, for me, that film just works. I think it's a fabulous film. And it's also, it's very synonymous with dates with me. There's a lot of... Okay, so when this film was released in 2004, yeah. I mean, I was super excited by the fact that we was getting a Punisher film, a new Punisher film, where he's actually wearing the skull. After obviously you had Dolph Lundgren one, and I loved Dolph Lundgren's.
Uh-huh.
But to actually see the character on screen in Skull, for me was just brilliant. And in 2004, the release date for this was in America was April 16th, and April 16th was my birthday.
Uh-huh.
So for me, it was like, my favorite comic character of all time that I've read for, you know, nigh on 20 years at that point, is finally getting a new film on my birthday in America.
Oh, a lot of details to make it special. Very nice.
Yeah. And then in this country, in the UK, the release date was September the 24th. Uh-huh. Right? Now, on September the 24th, the day this came out in the cinema over here, I actually had a really nasty motorbike crash. That put me in hospital for some considerable time.
Really?
And I couldn't walk for 5 months.
Oh, that's too sad. I'm so sorry it happened, man.
No, that's fine. I've got scarring all across my face that you can't really see now, sort of grown out. But I had a big hole right across my face, all up over my eyes. My nose was torn open by the visor poking in. So this
and you live all right now. It's all gone.
Yeah, I'm fine. I can walk. It wasn't that I broke anything. It was just I had such severe injuries to my lower back that I couldn't get up and walk. So for me, the dates for that film, the release dates are very synonymous with events in life, being my favourite character as well. And it's just a film, and I think it's I'm gutted that Thomas Jane never got the opportunity to do a sequel. That they, he lobbied for a sequel. He wanted a sequel. He pushed and pushed for a sequel. And what I remember, nothing was being done, nothing was being said. And then, it felt like the day after Thomas Jane said, "Look, I've got to step away from this now because I'm putting all this effort into it and nothing's coming back. I've got to focus my career elsewhere." It was like the next day, Lionsgate went and announced, "We're doing a new Punisher film with Ray Stevenson in the role." It was like they were waiting for Thomas Jane to, But no, it's a film I love.
And the next one was mean. He was mean as a Punisher. He was all right. But I loved them both.
Yeah, Ray Stevenson looked the part. He very much looked like the comic version of the Punisher. I'll give him that. He had a good, and he had nice nuances in his character as well.
And John Travolta as a villain, he was really doing fine.
Yeah, this had a good cast to it. when you consider the cast that this had, because obviously you had, you know, Thomas Jane was up and coming, he was good. John Travolta's always watchable. Roy Scheider, you know, it's funny I should mention Roy Scheider, but there we go. Roy Scheider was in it, you know. Who else was in it? Oh, I forget their names now. But it had a good cast. It had a really good cast that I liked.
Uh-huh.
You know,
yes.
Rebecca Romijn was in it. You know, as the flatmate, the woman. Yeah, and the geezer who was, I forget his name, the fella who was Thomas John Travolta was number two in it. He was the bad guy in The Postman, and he was in the TV series Falling Skies. I really like him. I can't remember his name. It eludes me. So it had a good cast that intrigued me as well, you know.
Look, this is a really good list, actually. I believe I'll give a chance to Die Hard again to remember it. And also this Punisher. I have the DVD, but I've seen the Blu-ray a couple of times. I think I'll buy it from JB Hi-Fi. And I want to watch it again because, yeah, John Travolta was really, he was a good villain.
I love the film. I love the film.
Okay, AJ. So look, our time is limited, as you know. I want to thank you very much for joining.
Is that half hour done already?
What's that?
What is our time up? Because I haven't got time on screen. How much is left?
I have the time on the screen. We have just 1.5 minutes.
Okay, so, the last one. The last film.
Okay, let me see. Oh, Jaws. That's awesome.
Yeah, my favorite film of all time.
Ah. Oh.
What needs to be said about?
And it's Lenticular 2.
It is, yeah. It's like a special edition with a book and all that in there.
That's beautiful. Yeah. Oh, this is okay. And the guy playing in this movie, he's also in Lil Fanda.
And in The Punisher.
And in The Punisher, yeah, that's right.
Roy Scheider, yeah. So I've done that quite well.
Yeah. Look, we couldn't talk too much on the Jaws, actually. It's really scary. It was very scary when I was a child, but maybe next time we can do it.
Absolutely. So,
AJ, thanks for being a guest in Movie Monster. I really appreciate it.
Thank you for having me on.
So next time, maybe we can do it longer. But for today, absolutely. I just want to thank you so much. So we are finishing episode 19 of Movie Monster. Thanks for watching, guys. So see you in the next episode. Bye.
Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye.